Yes.
Absolutely not.
I have.
All right. Gavin has. That's all we need to know. That's all we need to know. We don't want to go into any spoilers. Bo, but this was crazy. It broke a lot of history, right?
Broke, like, every record that movies have ever made.
Like, perfect.
It made $1.2 billion opening weekend. It made $350 million domestically. Both of those are records. And, like, just to put it in perspective, what's considered a really successful blockbuster makes $1 billion over its entire run.
Right.
They made it in 3 days.
That's mind-boggling. Just the amount of money that they made, like you said, over just opening weekend. But then I'm not also surprised that they broke the records like that.
Right.
All right, speaking of record breakers, there's a new record holder in the music world, and it belongs to none other but Taylor Swift.
Yeah, that's right. So Taylor Swift dropped her new song and video called Me on Friday. And the music video shattered the record for the most views on Vimeo in 24 hours with more than 65 million views. Now, Taylor Swift now holds the three of the top five 24-hour records. The video features Brandon Urie from Panic at the Disco. And, of course, we're playing it all the time here on 106.5
The End. The video's pretty dope.
Their video looks like a bunch of Easter M&Ms dancing.
But, and she's wearing a suit, which you like when ladies wear suits.
I do like it when ladies wear suits.
All right, well, good. I will note that next time I see you guys on Monday. I was going to ask you if you were playing it a lot, and it sounds like you guys, it is on your rotation, like, all the time, right?
Yeah, you can't turn on 106.5 The End without hearing us or Taylor Swift, pretty much.
Love it. All right, a pair of popular stars are teaming up for a new Netflix movie.
Yeah, Jennifer Aniston and Adam Sandler are starring in a new mystery comedy called Murder Mystery, the Netflix movie. It follows a couple who become suspects in a murder investigation while they are on their honeymoon. Now, you guys might remember these two worked together in 2011 with Just Go With It.
Right.
What is your favorite Adam Sandler movie?
My favorite Adam Sandler movie is the one that Adam Sandler's not in.
Okay.
Yeah, spoiler alert for this movie. The mystery is whether or not it will be funny. It won't be.
Okay, look, the Netflix does it. It's going to be good.
No, Netflix has an awful lot of misses.
Oh, man, Gavin. I'm a little weirded out with the mustache. Adam Sandler looks like my dad a little bit, so it's kind of weird.
Oh, don't say that about your dad.
I'll bet your dad's funnier.
Spoiler alert, it's your dad.
It is my dad. All right, before we let you guys go, you just made a major announcement about a big event on your calendar.
Yeah, that's right. So we're excited about the Festival of Dreams. It goes down on Saturday, June 8th. It's at the Grounds in Roseville. It's a day filled with superheroes and princesses. And if you're looking for something to do to bring the kids, we'll have bounce houses. Plus, you can get the tea party tickets where you can have lunch, not only with all of these superheroes and princesses and stuff, but we'll be out there.
Mm-hmm.
So you can come see us.
And no Adam Sandler.
Right. And no Adam Sandler.
Or your dad.
Or my dad. Okay, well, maybe I'll invite my dad.
Tickets at thefestivalofdreams.com.
Thefestivalofdreams.com. Thank you guys so much. We will see you guys next week. And go ahead. What a great cause to be able to give back to. On over to you, Simone and May.
Thank you, Martina. Never go to a pool party alone
again.
We'll show you the inflatable boyfriend floaty that's taking the internet by storm. That's coming up in the 9 o'clock hour.
Don't miss a traffic or weather update while you're on the road. Get the latest from Adam and Martina on 96.9 The Eagle.